In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Good morning, brothers and sisters. We offer this holy sacrifice of the Mass especially for the sake of our parish community. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Show us, O Lord, your mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, let us feel your compassion more readily during these days when, by your gift, we have known it more fully, so that those you have freed from the darkness of error may cling more firmly to the teachings of your truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The angel of the Lord spoke to Philip, "Get up and head south on the road that goes down from Jerusalem to Gaza, the desert route." So he got up and set out. Now there was an Ethiopian eunuch, a court official of the Candace, that is, the queen of the Ethiopians, in charge of her entire treasury, who had come to Jerusalem to worship and was returning home. Seated in his chariot, he was reading the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit said to Philip, "Go and join up with that chariot." Philip ran up and heard him reading Isaiah the prophet and said, "Do you understand what you are reading?" He replied, "How can I unless someone instructs me?" So he invited Philip to get in and sit with him. This was the scripture passage he was reading. "Like a sheep he was led to the slaughter, and as a lamb before its shearer is silent, so he opened not his mouth. In his humiliation, justice was denied him. Who would tell of his posterity? For his life is taken from the earth." Then the eunuch said to Philip in reply, "I beg you, about whom is the prophet saying this? About himself or about someone else?" Then Philip opened his mouth, and beginning with the scripture passage, he proclaimed Jesus to him. As they traveled along the road, they came to some water, and the eunuch said, "Look, there is water. What is to prevent my being baptized?" Then he ordered the chariot to stop, and Philip and the eunuch both went down into the water, and he baptized him. When they came out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord snatched Philip away, and the eunuch saw him no more, but continued on his way rejoicing. Philip came to Azotus, and went about proclaiming the good news to all the towns until he reached Caesarea. The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Bless our God, ye peoples. Loudly sound his praise. He has given life to our souls, and has not let our feet slip. Hear now, all you who fear God, why I declare what he has done for me. When I appealed to him in words, praise was on the tip of my tongue. Blessed be God who refused me not, my prayer or his kindness. Alleluia. Living bread that came down from heaven, says the Lord. Whoever eats this bread will live forever.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the crowds, "No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draw him, and I will raise him on the last day. It is written in the prophets, 'They shall all be taught by God.' Everyone who listens to my Father and learns from him comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except the one who is from God. He has seen the Father. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate the manna in the desert, but they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world." The Gospel of the Lord. If we believe in God, it's because he has drawn us to him. It is by grace that we have faith. It is by grace that we belong to his church. It is by grace that we do all the good we can. It is by grace that we forgive each other, that we believe in him. Everything is grace. Everything is a gift of God. But we are here because we have met mediators between God and us, people who have taught us about him, people who have taught us about the gospel, about the church, about the sacraments. God has had instruments for us to know him and for us to change of life, for us to start a process of conversion. Jesus says, "Whoever believes in me has eternal life," and that person has eternal life because that person has started to change of life. Because whenever we believe Jesus, a process of conversion starts immediately. If we really say, "Lord, I believe that everything you have taught me, everything you have shown me for my salvation is true," then I'll start to change my life. But everything is grace. Even the decision that we make to start a new life is a grace of God. We collaborate with his grace. God does not force us to believe in him. We let him work in us. And our holiness is a result of his grace. And this is what we see in the first reading. We see this Ethiopian who went to Jerusalem to worship the Lord. So he has a notion about the true one God, a notion about the true one religion, but of course he needs that completion of that revelation, which is Jesus Christ, and he's reading the Old Testament, a passage from the prophet Isaiah, and he doesn't understand. He needs He needs someone to teach him about that. And and that's when he meets Philip. Philip is an instrument of the Holy Spirit. Notice that the Holy Spirit says, go and join up with that chariot. The Spirit leads him to that person who is sincerely looking for the truth. So whenever you are looking for the truth and you are honest and you are sincere and you're really open to know the truth, the Lord will help you. The Lord will put someone in your path so you may learn more about him and you know the truth in its fullness. And of course, this man starts, you know, to listen, and then he says, I want to be baptized. Now I understand what I have been reading. I have met Jesus Christ. He's the truth. Now I understand that he's the Son of God. I want that life he promises me. And he's baptized. He received eternal life because he believes in Christ. But he has believed in him because someone has taught him about him. The church is the instrument that God has put in the world for us to know him in fullness. The church is there for us to know more about Jesus and to enter into full communion with Christ and his revelation. And notice that in today's gospel, and I think this is important to know because of what we're going to listen tomorrow and the day after tomorrow, Saturday, Jesus says, okay, if you believe in me, you are receiving into your life the bread that has come down from heaven. But then there is an important change at the very end of this gospel, and that announces the Eucharist. And there he says, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. And the bread, and here's the change, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. From now on, he's going to insist over and over and again that for us to have eternal life, we have to eat his flesh, literally. Before he was saying, a way you can eat my flesh, to eat this bread that has come down from heaven is by believing in my words. And this is a grace of God to believe in me. But for you to believe in me, you have to collaborate with the grace of God. You have to be honest and you have to truly search the truth. And you will be granted, the faith will be granted to you if you're open to God's grace, if you're honest, if you're sincere, if you're willing to change your life. But then there is an important change. The flesh, he says, the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. And the discourse changes here. And from this point on, the people who are listening to him are going to start to struggle. To the point that they will scandalize and say, how can this man give his own flesh for us to live? And at the end of this discourse, of this speech of Jesus, the people will turn around and abandon him. And then he will turn to his apostles and says, will you also leave? Will you also abandon me? And then Peter would say these words, only you have words of life eternal. So as you study the words, you know, the gospel was written in Greek. As you start looking for the words and the words that Jesus starts to use, there is a essential change in his discourse, in his speech. And that's why, one first part of this discourse, this speech, believe in me. Today we know that it is a grace to believe in Christ. And that grace starts to work on us as we are willing to change of life. There is no sanctity, there is no holiness, there is no eternal life unless we are willing to change of life, to change our mindset, to change our beliefs, to change our way of life. And now, from now on, the Lord is going to add something very important. You have to believe in me, yes, for you to have life. But in addition to this, and this is indispensable, you have to eat my flesh. You have to gnaw my flesh. And this is the Eucharist. So for us to have eternal life, we need these two things: to believe in Christ and to eat the body and blood of Christ. And this is how we are anticipating our own resurrection. And he will insist on this, and you will see this in the following days. So let us give thanks to the Lord for the gift of faith. Thank you, Lord, because I believe in you. Thank you for my teachers, for my friends, those who have led me to know you, to meet you, to know your love, to know the truth, to know the gospel. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. And I want to let you know that I am willing to continue in this process of conversion with your grace, with your help. Let us pray in silence. Let us pray, brothers and sisters, for the church, the world, and for one another.
For our Holy Father, our bishops, priests, and deacons, that they might be as responsive to the movement of the Spirit as Philip was, letting themselves be placed wherever the souls are searching for the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace, that we may all be taught by God to come to Jesus as the model for all truth, justice, and courageous self-sacrifice to give life to the world. Let us pray to the Lord. For all of us sharing this Eucharist, feeding upon the flesh of the Lord, that they may be willing to give our lives generously for one another as he did, let us pray to the Lord. That God may not refuse our prayer or his kindness for all the special intentions we bring to this holy sacrifice, let us pray to the Lord. For those who have died, that Jesus, who will raise us all on the last day, may open to them the gates of heaven in welcome and joy, let us pray to the Lord.
God of heaven and earth, listen graciously to the prayers that we humbly present to you, trusting in your divine providence. In the name of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of all to fulfillment in the reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Nelson our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you through all the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Christ died for all, that those who live may live no longer for themselves, but for him who died for them and is risen. Alleluia. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Regina Celi, letare, alleluia, quia, quem meruisti portare, alleluia, resurrexit, sicut dixit, alleluia, ora pro nobis Deum, alleluia.